I promise to be true, honest, loyal, and faithful to you. I promise to be the most patient, loving, and caring father and role model to our children. I promise to never judge you, your late-night sweet indulgence, and always partake in said indulging to help you not feel so guilty, leading us through the most loving, adventurous, fruitful, and exciting life I can give to you until my final breath. You're my best friend, my soulmate, and I'm excited to grow old with you.
So here are my promises to you. I promise to love and to be true to only you. I promise to comfort you in your times of need. I promise to stand by your side through good and bad times. I promise to be the best teammate as long as I'm not losing. I promise to be a loving wife and nurturing mother to our children. I promise to cherish every moment and never taking you for granted. I promise to be your number one fan and your biggest cheerleader. I will always give you 100% of myself. You are my best friend, my soulmate, and I can't imagine continuing through this crazy life without you by my side.
I just know that I grew up being a heavyweight, punching bag, and Joe is the boxer. But I think that has a lot to do with why I'm his best man. He was always there to beat up on me, and I was always there to take it. Well, moves on from that. It goes into work. We worked together the last 2 years, and I couldn't imagine working anywhere else than anybody else. Probably is the place I want to be. And from there it goes on to our line of friends. We got Josh Blackburn, Robbie Vaughn, Brandon Noss, Gilseth, and Jordan. And each one of them should be his best man, as well as me. Each guy that's sitting here in his groomsman category, I've learned something from each of them, and I've taken it to my heart, and I've kept it with me. They don't know what it is, and I don't know what it is, but each one of them they're very special guys. And then from there it goes into what me and Joey like to do. We like to go real fast. And I always grew up being his co-pilot. We don't do it much more, except for in the work truck. We always have to go slow. So we have like CDLs and things now. But it all started out in the Audi and just sideways, going way too fast around corners in the ice. And I can't really explain it too well, but it means a lot. And there goes back to family. Just me and Joe growing up together, and we found each other growing up, and we stayed tight through it, and we're still there as well as every other sibling I have. But Joe's definitely one of the tightest sibling the relationships that I have. And thanks, Joe, for calling me out to be your best man. And thank you, everybody, for being here.
So as most of you know, I'm Coral's sister. And when I found out Joey proposed, I automatically started crying. And first it was because I was hyping for her. And then I was thinking, my sister? Coral? She's getting married? Like, what? I was like, wait, do we have the right person here? Because I'm not sure. Growing up, we never saw eye to eye. I was always the tattletale and crying just to see her get in trouble. We were complete opposites. And I remember one day I wanted a Britney Spears haircut where she had it flared out like this. Coral got the scissors and basically gave me a mullet. I didn't think I could trust her after that. But through the years, Coral's become one of the most influential people in my life. She's been through one hell of a ride. And it's created her into one of the most strongest, warm-hearted, caring people I know. Sorry. Everything she's accomplished and overcome has made her into who she is today, and believe it or not, who I am today. I really wouldn't be who I am now if it wasn't for you. Watching her with basically the whole world against her, she never ever gave up. She taught me to never listen to the people who doubt me, because in the end, everything happens for a reason. And that's where Joey comes in. Coral and Joey are together for a reason, and they're getting married for a reason. And that reason is love. I know that sounds cliche, but when I met Joey and I saw how Coral and him acted together, I knew they were perfect. She's constantly laughing with him, and personally, I've never seen Coral so genuinely happy with a guy like Joey in her entire life. He fits right into our crazy family. Not saying he's crazy, but he's just able to tolerate us all in the same room, which most of you know is very hard to do. And please stay together for a very, very long time. You guys are the only people I don't feel guilty about coming over uninvited to raid your kitchen. But I really can't express how happy I am for you both. I can't think of a better man than Joey to be your husband, a father for the boys, and a new addition to this family. I love you both so very much, and I wish you the best as Mr. and Mrs. Head.
How about that drive-in? That's from The Hangover. You write that down. Anyway, first time I noticed Joey and Coral hanging out was when me and Joey were living together in Monroe, and him and Coral started hanging out there at my place, and I knew something was different because I stopped getting woken up in the morning, Saturday mornings, by Joey's burping. And then maybe his keeping his manners in check. And he also used to, we have wood fire, and he used to always build the fire, and he stopped building the fire because it's always too hot in there. Coral's too hot. It's always too hot. So hot in here. But for seriousness, I know they're great together. I've seen how Joey's jumped in there with the boys, and they've raised them boys great. It's hard to find too many, or another set of well-mannered boys just like that. And you can just tell from that, and it's just so inspiring to see how you guys raised them up right. They're polite, they manner. And you can just tell there's a lot of respect. I don't know, you guys know how to treat each other, and it's just, it's good. Love you guys. I know you guys will be great. Thanks.
Me and Joey have known each other and good friends, me and Joey and Brandon, since we were 12 years old, I believe. And I remember my mom actually bringing me to Brandon's house, and we pull up and we just look to our right. we see Joey hauling Josh. He has a cast on his hand. He was about 6 years old, I believe, at the time. Hauling him into one of those cars behind his bike, and he flips upside down into the car, into the ditch, and my mom's going, who is that? One story I remember is I brought Joey over to my grandparents' house, and I used to mow their lawn every summer and everything, so I brought him over, and my grandma used to drive school buses, and he comes over. They were gone at the time, so we just come over. I go, hey, just sit in the living room, and I'll mow the lawn. So I mow the lawn. We come back down. We sit down. Well, all of a sudden, they come in, and my grandpa comes in with a little pail. It's basically rusted through the bottom, and he has a little pail of blackberries, and he's like, oh, we just came back from picking blackberries, and my grandma comes in right after him, and Joey just kind of looks at me and goes, this is like straight out of a book. Like, this is straight out of a movie. And I'm like, yeah. And then I go, oh, this is Joey Head. And my grandma goes, Joey Head, why does that sound familiar? And she's sitting there thinking about it. And she goes, well, sit down. I'll make you guys milkshakes. And then he looks at me again and he goes, are you serious? And so she makes us milkshakes, and we're sitting there, and then, sandwiches and everything, and she's mayonnaise, just so much mayonnaise, but it was so good. And we eat the milkshake, and I can tell my grandma's still thinking. She's like, why does that sound familiar? Why does the head name sound familiar? And she goes, I remember. She goes, I drove all the way, did my rounds to the bus stop when... And this is years and years ago. This is when Joey was probably, first grade. And he goes, and she drove it back to the bus barn, right? And she goes to leave, and she goes, does the last rounds through the bus, and Joey's sitting there sleeping in the back. And Joey, and my grandma goes, what? And so he has to call his parents and everything, and has a meeting. So ever since this, she remembered the last name Head, and she thought it was really funny that, it all came around to me being friends, and she had that memory of Joey sleeping in the back of the bus. But I kind of bring up that story because I kind of want to, like, I want to imagine your guys' marriage like them. Like, I want to imagine, like, 40 years down the road, I want to see you guys coming in with the pail, and you're like, I got my blackberries, And I want our kids to see... the future thing, like, that reminds me of a book, like, I want to see your guys' marriage like that, and I want my kids to see your guys and your kids to see our marriage like a book, basically. So that's all I got.
There must be something in the water, and there must be something about your daughter. She said, I love you nothing but a monster. My love ain't nothing but a monster with two heads. Ooh. All I see, I love's a monster with two heads, one heart.
Don't look at the camera.